Welcome to the 2007 CREST Awards, where the City of Cupertino recognizes extra steps taken on behalf of the community. Before we start, let's take a look back at some of the past CREST Award recipients. Cupertino City Manager, David Knapp.
Thank you very much for being here tonight. You can measure the greatness of a city by the extent to which her residents care for and take responsibility for each other. And by that measure, Cupertino is truly a great city. The four people that we are honoring tonight are shining examples for us all. They care for the poor, and the sick, and the needy. They provide shelter. They make senior services available. And they raise money to support education. They know that it really is better to give than to receive. They're part of Cupertino's phenomenal tradition of volunteering. And another term for volunteer is responsible citizen. And now it's my honor and pleasure to introduce Cupertino's most responsible citizen, our own mayor, Chris Wang.
Wow. Well, as the mayor, at least I get the privilege to welcome you all to the CREST Award ceremony. And we have full council here. I believe my council colleagues will agree with me that this is one of the most joyful, thankful events that we attend. Cupertino has so many people. They contributed their time, their energy, and everything to help us to build the community better and better. And a lot of them are so humble and shy and stay behind the scene. And we get sitting in front of the spotlight. So this is a great opportunity that we remember and to thank all the volunteers in our community. We can thank them all at once, but we cannot recognize them all at once. So we, CREST Award, it's through the nomination, we pick a few the top volunteers throughout the past years that we can recognize here tonight. And before I start the award, I would like to share a small story with you. Earlier this year, I received a invitation from Korea. A citizen that used to live in Cupertino, a Korean, he received a award many, many years ago when he was in Cupertino. He remembers that. He probably didn't remember who nominated him or who presented a award to him, but he does remember City Cupertino, the other end of the world, that he had received this award. And that he wanted to invite the mayor from City Cupertino to attend his retirement party. I couldn't go, but I was so touched by this, you know, word, this experience that he expressed. He remembered he took it seriously about this honor, and I want to share with all the recipients that an extra step he took now make a really nice memorable mark on his life a journey. So that's my little story to share and to congratulate all the recipients tonight. Now, let's start our word. And first, I would like to have Vice Mayor Patrick Kwok come forward and start the award and introduce the recipient, the first recipient.
Thank you very much, Mayor Wang. It is my extreme honor this evening to present the first CREST recipient award to Sean Poyer. Sean has rolled the video, please.
Old timers in Cupertino may remember a big citywide carnival that took place every year from the mid-1950s to the mid-70s. 3 years ago, after a 30-year hiatus, the carnival came back to town, and Sean Poyer was a key player in bringing it home. In 2004, the school board at St. Joseph of Cupertino School decided there were two very good reasons for reviving the old three-day carnival. It would help raise funds for the school, and it would be a great way to build community. All they needed were about 250 volunteers and a few good leaders. Sean stepped up that year to serve as the main chairman, and that's been a post that he's held for the past 3 years. True to form, he'll be in the same spot this year when the Family Fun Festival takes place at the end of September. As anyone can imagine, overseeing 15 carnival rides, dozens of food and game booths, a mini flea market, a coffee shop, talent show, and 3 days of nonstop entertainment can be pretty intense. But Sean takes it all in stride. His work begins months and months before the event as he spends countless hours planning strategy and recruiting other volunteers. On actual carnival days, he's on site early directing squads of workers on walkie-talkies and troubleshooting from one end of the carnival to the other. Sean leads by example, and his dedication combined with his can-do attitude is a powerful tool for bringing people together.
Sean, could you please come up? Sean is nominated because of the tremendous leadership and dedication. As the video states that after 30 years of hiatus, you brought back the Family Festival to St. Joseph of Cupertino. There's a lot of hard work, a lot of dedications to bring the volunteers together and get going and turn it into a very, very successful festival. And the goal of the festival is to bring the community together, at the same time raise funds for the retirement of the teachers. And Sean is very, very quiet. I get to know him about 3 years. And he told me during the festivals, when you see the people on the flywheel, the people watching the magic show, the family crafts, the talent shows, and all the ethnic foods, and most important, when you see the great Joe Sereno band and concert come back 3 years in a row, entertaining people of all ages. And you all, the rewarding part of it is to get a smile from all these people. That is very rewarding. And that is the type of people Sean is. And I want to also express convey the congratulations from all the pastors of St. Joseph of Cupertino and the staff for you being receiving the award. Unfortunately, they have a retreat all week this week, but they asked me to congratulate you on your great award for these achievements and all the voluntary work that you've done for the entire Cupertino communities. And I commend you for all this and congratulate you for the achievements. Joe? Would you like to say something?
Well, Patrick Kwok asked me to say a few words coming in the room tonight, and it's really hard to put it all in a few words. It's an overwhelming experience. I need to recognize a couple people that brought me into this event that gave me the opportunity to accept this award. Chris Valdez and Jan Orvik, two of the head cheerleaders in Carnival Year One. Two wonderful people. We had a phenomenal time working together. We created the Carnival 14, 16 months before the actual event took place. Countless hours. And again, it's so hard to put such an overwhelming event into a few words, but like my word with Barbara Hill year after year after year, my magic award is just phenomenal. It's a phenomenal experience seeing the people leave at the end of the evening with smiles on their faces. And I think my main drive that brings me back year after year is my two wonderful kids sitting out there. If I ever stepped down, my daughter would give me the third degree. With all that said, I can't thank you enough for this. Thanks.
It is my honor to ask to present the most senior part of our city council, Richard Orenthal. I think this is his last year sitting on the council and the last CREST Award. Please join me in giving Richard a round of applause.
Patrick, I'm not sure I'm the most senior member in all respects, but I appreciate the introduction. I've had a lot of chance to be up here. It's always a great thrill to honor volunteers, and I'm excited today. I get to introduce Mary Ellen Hennig.
Sitting on a piano bench, tapping out the notes of a church hymn, Mary Ellen Hennig is not just making beautiful music, she's living the message of the song. The message is love, and it plays out loud and clear in Mary Ellen's everyday life. All creatures, great and small, from lost cats and abandoned chickens to hospital patients and homeless men, find refuge in a soft heart that always has room for one more. For more than 10 years, Mary Ellen has worked with Cupertino Community Services' Faith in Action program, helping to arrange meals every night of the year for clients of the rotating shelter, men struggling to find permanent jobs and housing. Not a Thanksgiving day goes by that doesn't find Mary Ellen busy making sure that no one in the shelter goes without a full-course turkey dinner. Last year, when the rotating shelter came to St. Joseph's in Cupertino, Mary Ellen chaired the event, working with other volunteers to provide daily meals for more than 50 people. A resident of Cupertino for more than 30 years, Mary Ellen raised two children here with her husband, Falk. She has always been active in her church and community, often merging her passion for music and song with her volunteer work. For private events, as well as regular church services and special functions, she generously shares her skills on piano and organ, never asking for compensation or recognition. Whether she's visiting a local hospital or convalescent home, or cooking a meal for the rotating shelter, Mary Ellen puts into action the words of the sacred songs she plays. And in every case, she hits all the right notes.
Mary Ellen, could you join me, please, up here on the stage? So, besides what you see there on the screen, Mary Ellen has helped a lot at the rotating shelter. That's a cause that's dear to my heart. I've had the fortune of helping there too, and it kind of epitomizes the spirit of volunteerism in Cupertino. You know, in Cupertino, you don't see many homeless people, and the ones that are here, we take care of. And the community rallies together to make sure these fellows are fed. They get a shower. They have the chance to get back to work. We provide them some help in finding work through the rotating shelter. But when we say we, it's other community members. It's people like Mary Ellen who care for other people. And she cares for not only people but animals too. I guess you're a friend of the animals. But we see her and hear about her mostly as she cares for other people in the parish. She visits people that are homebound. She recently took care of all the arrangements for a funeral for a family that just wasn't feeling up to it. It's anything that you think about, the kind of care that you'd like to see from a friend. Mary Ellen is a friend to anybody in the community, whether you're homeless or a fellow parishioner. So I'm really proud to be standing up here with her. And we have a number of things here. There's a proclamation which is from the city, from the mayor and the city council, thanking her for her valuable contributions as a volunteer in the community. There's this nice glass award that she'll put up on a bookcase. And finally, our county supervisor, Liz Niss, has sent these certificates of commendation from the Board of Supervisors. So all of these are yours, and you've earned these through hard work and love. So thank you very much, Mary Ellen.
Thank you very much. And you know, I do work with so many people who also are volunteers and who go extra steps and who give so much. But I also work with people who go the extra step in their jobs. And I feel like just I'm representing many people that I work with who do so much. I feel like serving others is a responsibility and an obligation that everyone has, but it's also a great joy and a great pleasure to do so. And it really does bring a lot of fulfillment and joy into my life. And I feel like I am serving God when I serve other people. So I'm grateful for that privilege. I'm grateful for the health and the strength and the abilities that I may have that I can share with others. Thank you.
For the next award, we'll have my good colleague and good friend, Dolly Sandoval, come up and present. Dolly?
Good evening. It's my honor to give the next award to Mary Lou Caldwell. Let us share a little bit about Mary Lou with you.
Any woman who raises nine sons and a daughter is certainly a force to be reckoned with. But Mary Lou Caldwell's heroics go way beyond her role as a devoted mother. For more than 47 years, ever since she moved to Cupertino, the formidable Mary Lou has served her community as a volunteer, doing what she does best, taking care of people. A former registered nurse, she left the profession to raise her large family and to immerse herself in her children's schools as a parent volunteer. For the past 15 years, she has been actively involved in YLI, a Catholic women's charitable organization that raises funds for nonprofit groups such as Guide Dogs for the Blind, St. Jude's Hospital, and the Lucille Packard Children's Hospital. Her work with YLI also includes providing food for local homeless shelters and raising money for scholarships awarded to needy students. At St. Joseph of Cupertino Church, her face has long been a familiar one. She's helped clean the altars every week without fail for the past two decades. She also participates in church services and schedules other volunteers. In addition, she visits those who are ill and homebound, bringing comfort, laughter, and Holy Communion. Always by her side throughout the years of service was Dick, Mary Lou's husband of 51 years and a tireless volunteer himself. When cancer claimed him 2 years ago and her own health problems made it difficult to get around, Mary Lou's energy faltered. But not for long. Her love of people, her need to nurture, her warm and generous nature predictably supplied the fuel for a volunteer spirit that is still going strong today.
As you just saw from the video, Mary Lou has been challenged by a number of things in her life here. 10 kids, for starters. She's been blessed by a number of things, too. 11 grandchildren, I understand. Mary Lou has really epitomized what Crest Award is all about. She has served diligently at St. Joseph's School as a school board member, as a volunteer, running the bingo programs. She's raised money, as you heard, for the homeless shelter, to get people that step, give them a stepping stone in life, the underdog, those who are meeting hard times. Mary Lou has overcome many, many obstacles and asked for nothing in return. She shared her smile and her friendship and her compassion with hundreds of people throughout the years. Mary Lou, you've taken extra steps to make our community here in Cupertino what it is. Thank you for your love and compassion. Would you join me up on stage? I probably should have asked that first. Mary Lou started her career as a registered nurse and moved on as really a professional volunteer without the pay. Mary Lou, thank you for taking those extra steps.
That is perfect. Patrick told me to write something and I did.
He is a wise man.
I had wanted to come up with a bunch of papers to upset everybody and think, oh my goodness, she's going to be up there for hours, but I won't be.
I will hold this, or you can hold it.
Okay. I'd like to thank Mayor Chris Wang, Dolly Sandoval, Patrick Kwok, council members, and the city of Cupertino for giving me this Crest Award. I am standing here not alone, but with the spirit of my deceased husband, Dick Caldwell, who had tirelessly worked for the community and also was bingo chairman at St. Joseph's for 30 years. I stand with the support of my family, 1 daughter, 9 sons, 11 grandchildren, daughter-in-laws, and many good and faithful friends in Cupertino, the Young Ladies Institute, and St. Joseph's Parish community. My life since I moved to Cupertino 47 years ago has been filled with a myriad of activities, helping others or causes in need, such as visiting the sick, the lonely, the shut-ins, crocheting Afghans for the newborns in Santa Clara County, being chairman for various school, church, and YLI activities, raising funds for different charities such as Lucille Packard Children's Hospital, St. Jude's Children's Hospital, Guide Dogs for the Blind, and the Diaper Fund for the Santa Clara County Newborns. I have been cooking, shopping, serving, and cleaning up after many barbecues with my husband. In school, I helped with teacher's aides correcting papers. My nursing degree has not gone for naught, for I was the neighborhood nurse. Doing these things have given purpose to my life. It is my way of thanking God for all the good things He has given me. Life is like a kaleidoscope, ever-changing, offering new opportunities and choices every day, helping the lonely and vulnerable, listening to others' problems and needs, being present for them, offering care and concern, bringing a sense of joy, offering them an opportunity to smile and laugh, thereby forgetting their own problems and needs. In all of these activities, I have received only one threat. It's from my dearest and longtime friends, Minnie Butera and Virginia Puzar. They intend to bring duct tape for my mouth. They encourage me to sit on my hands and promise to elbow me in the ribs if I volunteer for anything else. They are my friends, always there with support and helping hands. I accept this award for each and every one of you present. I am grateful for the opportunity to serve. It has been a gratifying experience to meet other people, and it has enriched my faith through giving and serving. Our children imitate what they see, and I hope I have been a good example. Thank you.
Are any of those children or grandchildren here tonight?
Yes,
and would they like to stand?
Yes.
Thank you for sharing your mother or your grandmother with the Cupertino community. I'd like to next introduce my colleague on the City Council, Councilman Orrin Mahoney.
So I think everybody knows that I'm the junior councilman, at least by tenure, if not by age. We'll talk about that later. I'm not only the most junior council member, but last year I was out of the country when the Crest Awards were given, so this is actually my first chance to do this, and I just like to say it is one of the most rewarding and enjoyable things I think that we can do as a council, as council members, to reflect the great effort of volunteers in the community. So it's my honor tonight to introduce Helen Ho as our next Crest recipient.
Military recruiters and HR departments could learn a few things from Helen Ho, a volunteer extraordinaire at the Cupertino Senior Center. Helen's family, friends, neighbors, even casual acquaintances often find themselves helping out and fully immersed in senior center activities, thanks to the recruiting efforts of this hard-to-say-no-to engaging lady. Quiet and gracious, Helen began volunteering for the center about 8 years ago, assisting with programs and language translations at large events. She worked hard at encouraging non-English-speaking seniors to join the center and become involved. She found other translators who spoke Chinese, Korean, Farsi, and Japanese, asking them to help at health fairs, flu clinics, and medical lectures sponsored by the center. Today, Helen serves as chair of the Special Events Committee. She devotes hours to orchestrating such successful events as the Chinese New Year celebration, International Costume Show, Garden Party, and Hidden Treasures fundraiser. But that's not all. Helen is also a member of the center's volunteer advisory board, and she's the chair of the Host Hostess Committee, a group that is dear to her heart. Needless to say, Helen's volunteer activities are not confined to committee work. She'll step in wherever she's needed, and you can bet she'll bring along as many other helping hands as she can find.
Step over here and join me. While I definitely qualify for membership in the Senior Center, I haven't had the opportunity to avail myself of their services as I keep pretty busy with other things. So I don't know Helen personally, but in reading through the material, I think the thing that really touched me, and you heard about it there a little bit, is the work that she's done in bringing the cultures together in the Senior Center and therefore in the city of Cupertino. As I go around to different communities, one of the things I'm the most proud of the city of Cupertino is the work that has been done in that area and how well we're really a model, I think, in the whole U.S., and maybe in the world, but in the U.S. certainly, as a community that does that job, that's achieved that job. And Helen headed up a bridging, what was it called? Changing Demographics Committee. And again, a nice thing I think that reflects the community is the fact that committee is gone. That's turned into the special events committee that she's heading up now, doing a lot of the special events that you saw on the screen. So I think, you know, it's the work of Helen and a lot of other people out in the community that's continuing to build that reputation for the city of Cupertino, and I'm proud to give the award to Helen.
Thank you, City Council, and thank you for giving me this award. But I know I'm receiving this award also for the members of my committee, Special Event Committee, and Host Committee. I would like them to stand up and share this moment with me. Joyce, Connie, Virginia, Pearl, Mike and Evelyn. I'm very grateful for their help. They are always there when we need help. And also my friends who always come to answer my help, the last minute help in translation or in being a salesperson at Hidden Treasure. So here's could you stand up? May and Shirley. I think Alice, my friend, is not here. Oh, sorry, she's here. And I passed the hardest job of the volunteer to her. That is the same time translation for the medical seminar we have. And she's doing a wonderful job. And also, I have to thank Julia, the senior center's supervisor, for providing such a friendly atmosphere for the volunteer to work. And also, I have to thank Teresa Moe, our program coordinator. Please stand up. And she's always there to support and to help. Whatever idea we throw to her, she'll see if it's doable and she'll be helping us. And the most rewarding moment for me is when we have special event and I see all people from different races and different age sometimes, because the senior center's membership start as young as 50. So, and we have so different age and different ethnic group of people there. And I like to see them smile and laugh. And that's the most rewarding moment for me. And I thank you all for giving me this opportunity. And thank you for giving me the opportunity to stand here and thank all the members of my host committee and the special event committee and Julia and Teresa and all my friends who helped me at the last minute's call. And also my family there in the corner and the grandchildren, my son. Are they here? I cannot see, okay. Sorry. And my husband, and especially my sister and her husband, my brother-in-law, surprised me by flying up from Los Angeles to witness this moment. So I'm very blessed by good friends and a good family. Thank you all.
Hold on, don't go. We've got to get some pictures. It's now my pleasure to bring Mayor Wang back up to close out the ceremonies.
Wow, I'm thrilled. After hearing all this recipients' story, their introduction and video, I'm totally thrilled. And I also feel very fortunate. We have so many good citizens that helping us to build the community. Now, I would like to bring my colleagues back on the stage, and let's all together come on up here.
We don't sing, do we?
No, you just need to dance, yeah. I just want to say that all together, five of us here, we wanted to once again congratulate all the recipients. Thank you for your work, and your families, your friends, everybody here. Thank you so much for your support and your help. Maybe we should bring all four recipients back on the stage as well. If the family, come on up. If the family has the flower to present, or you would like to take individual photos with your presenters or with a group, this will be a good time. So you walk in, you see that we also prepared a reception in the lobby. But before I adjourn to that, I do want to recognize a group of outstanding staffs we have. That's led by the Public Relations Director, Rick Kissen. Where is it, Rick? Rick? Can't see you anywhere. And you see that we have three cameras here, and they're operated by Ray P. Robert. Yeah, and I remember, I know we also have one one new hire part-time, so also here, and some of the volunteers here. Let's give them a big round of applause. Thank you for them. So where's all the recipients? If you'd like to take photos now, no one to be first. Okay, we ready? We go out there we can toast there, and yeah. Come on up here. You have flowers and bring your family up here. Take a photo.
They say on Price is Right. Come on down.
Yeah, so you want to bring your families up here and take a photo together with council members? Or we can take a group photo all together.